Guys, I am back after a long period of absence with my lovely, funny, bubbly model Cynthia to do a makeup tutorial, and I'm going to start off with the Embryolisse Lait Crémé Concentré to moisturize her oily face. I practically do this on every skin type in order to prepare for foundation application. I go ahead with the MAC Cosmetics charged water, spray this all over her face to add a little bit of glow to that skin. Then I brush those brows using a brow brush in order to prep those brows for shaping and have them look really good. After this, I fill them in with the MAC Cosmetics brow pencil in spiked, and sometimes I mix that a little bit with some brow powder or with the NYX Cosmetics brow pencil in brunette. You could also use the Anastasia Beverly Hills brow gel or brow wiz. They are also good. When I'm done with that, I go ahead and shape those brows using the LA Girl Pro Concealer in Toffee for Cynthia, and I do this on the area below and above her brows, and I just make sure that I blend it really, really well before I start the foundation application or the eyeshadow application. And as you can see in the video, I'm using a blending brush from Coastal Scents. I do this below and above the brow area, and also, not shown in this video, I apply some brow gel after that just to have those little hairs set in really, really well. Fix them in place. When I'm done with that, I spray some MAC Cosmetics Prep and Prime Fix Spray all over his skin to prepare the face for foundation application. And while that sinks in, I apply the LA Girl Pro Conceal Concealer in Toffee on her eyelids in order to prepare the eyes for eyeshadow application. I set the concealer with the Laura Mercier setting powder, translucent setting powder in this case. And when I'm done, I take the MAC Cosmetics highlighter in Gold Deposit to highlight the brow bones to give the whole eye look a little subtle glow that you would see at the end of this video. A little goes a long way. I love this highlighter and I could really recommend it to any other makeup artist. When I'm done with that, I apply the NYX Cosmetics Jumbo pencil in Milk in order to have my eyeshadow colors pop. And in this case, I was using the Juvia's Place Saharan palette, and the eyeshadows I used to come up with this look were Zoya, Lulu, Fula, and Bororo. As transition colors, I used the Juvia's Place Saharan palette eyeshadow Jamila, and I mix that with the MAC Cosmetics single eyeshadow in Swiss Chocolate. I just blended out these eyeshadows together in order to create a really harmonious eyeshadow look, and in order to darken the outer area of her eyes, I used the Morphe brushes eyeshadow palette in 25A, an awesome nude palette for dark skins, and I use the dark brown eyeshadows in this palette to actually smoke out the outer area. So I brush off all the eyeshadow fallouts that you can see under her eye area, and when I'm done with this, I use the Inglow gel liner in number 77, pretty popular, the holy grail of many makeup artists, and I create a really subtle wing for this look. We're going for something natural and we try to keep everything really less dramatic. We had to do this. Well, I had to basically put my hand on the outer area of her eye and pull that skin a little bit in order to apply the eyeliner in a smooth and nice manner, so that eyeliner looks really nice, straight, and on fleek. And I'm using a pointed eyeliner brush for this purpose. The look looks like this. I'm pretty much satisfied. And we go ahead and apply the Laura Mercier foundation primer in Radiance. I apply it mostly on the T-zone area. I love this primer. This primer is becoming a huge holy grail for me. It is awesome. It gives the whole foundation look a subtle radiance. The whole skin is subtly radiant, and I could really recommend this to everybody. Now, I love mixing my foundations, and this is what I did in this tutorial as well. Lately, I have been in love, falling in love with the creamy foundations, like the Black Opal foundations and the MAC Studio Tech foundations. These foundations are just the bomb. So for Cynthia, I mixed the MAC Studio Tech foundation in number 48 with the Black Opal True Color foundation, stick foundation in Hazelnut and Karoub, and I mixed that with my little spatula, and I applied it on her face with the alcohol sponge that you can see right here, making sure that it really blends into her skin. Of course, using a damp beauty blender or a real technique sponge, I really dab her skin to have these foundation well distributed over her skin, make sure it sinks really well into her skin. Now, I'm going for a really natural look, so I opted for a concealer that is pretty much her skin tone, which is the case with the Mary Kay concealer in bronze 2, and I apply that on her under eye area and her T-zone, and make sure to blend that in really well after this. What you could also do is apply maybe a drop or two of a little lighter shade concealer in order to, make that highlighting area a little bit more bright. But I really loved these Mary Kay Bronze 2 concealer in this particular case. Pretty much looks like this, and I go ahead and start with concealing, and I still grab my Black Opal cream stick foundation, and this one is in Black Walnut, and I'm just using my stippling brush and I'm to apply a little amount of that cream foundation on her cheekbones and also around her jawbone, not shown in this video. I just wanted to show you how I apply this and try to blend it out using my stippling brush. For a better blending effect, you could always spray that stippling brush with some MAC Cosmetics Prep and Prime Fix Spray to blend everything really well together. It works also really well, but the stippling brush is a really good applicator for the contouring, cream contouring. When I'm done, I apply the MAC Cosmetics Studio Fix powders in NW45 and NW50 all over her face, avoiding the contouring area. And I'm just buffing that in. I'm not swiping it off. I'm just buffing in that foundation just to make sure, it blends in with the cream foundations that are already on her skin. I try to make the whole look not too matte. Or not too drying. I really just want to have something really natural for her skin. So I'm just really dabbing in a small amount of product on that face. It's really important. So when I'm done with powder application, generally I go straight ahead with blush application, or I also set the contouring. Really depends on what I'm trying to go for. But in this case, I left the contouring. I didn't really set it in. I applied the blush pretty much immediately after that, and I really applied a small amount of brush, and I'm using the e.l.f. Cosmetics blush palette to do this in sort of circular motions. And after that, I apply the MAC Cosmetics highlighter in Gold Deposit. As you can see, it gives it a beautiful subtle glow, to the whole look. Awesome. Then I went straight ahead to work on her lips. In this case, I lined her lips with the BH Cosmetics lip liner in Rouge, and I applied the Anastasia Beverly Hills red lipstick found in her lipstick palette. I don't know the name, I don't know the number. I have forgotten it, but you could always look it up, on the internet and see which one it is. It is really red, and I use a lip brush to actually blend the lipstick with the lip liner color, and it gives this awesome lip looks. And I go ahead with the Maybelline Mega Volume Black Angel Miss Manga mascara to prep those eyelashes for false lash application. So I'm using strip lashes that I bought from Amazon, and I basically lay that on top of her lashes really carefully, sometimes using my hands as well. And of course, I applied some lash glue over that to make sure that it really sticks well. So basically, it looks like this when I'm done, and I'm going to apply some more mascara after that to blend both natural and false lashes together. And this is how Cynthia looks finally. Look at her looking. Eye ready and prepped for the eye. All we need right now is a white dress to have her walk down the aisle. Those lashes are bae, honey. So beautiful. And I can't wait to show you more looks for me. Make sure you follow me on Facebook, on Instagram. And you could always call me up for your bookings. You could always call me up to learn how to do your own makeup, or also to learn more from me. Have a nice day and see you next time. Bye bye.